A new dawn, a new day. Welcome back from your winter break. Returning, without warning, is your second half of this school year, and just like all of you, BDU 2 is starting a new semester. Now with new faces to say hello to. Look at these precious little pumpkins, they don't know what they're getting into. Anyways, on with the show.
Hey, Blue Devils.
I'm Ben.
And I'm Melanie.
Welcome to the first show of the new year.
And you're watching the Blue Devil Update.
Martin Luther King Jr. Day is observed on the third Monday of January each year.
We gathered some facts for the day.
Martin Luther King Jr. Day is a federal holiday in the United States, celebrated every year on the third Monday of January to honor the life and legacy of civil rights leader Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. It's a day that focuses on the issues of civil rights, highlights the use of nonviolence to promote change, and calls people into public service.
Blue Devils, it's a brand new year.
Time to focus on taking care of yourself.
Remember, it's up to you to figure out what you want to do for your future.
But you are not alone. Reach out to your counselor for help.
Here are some tips.
I just want to talk to you briefly about every student to have an E in mind, whether it's enrolled in a school, it could be enlisted in the armed services, and then our final E is employment. So a lot of students choose to join the workforce. We are here to help you figure out which is the best fit for you.
Everyone, I'm Ms. Hartney here from the Counseling Department to remind you seniors that we are still in the midst of college application season. Don't forget that one of the important parts of completing and submitting your college applications is determining your residency. All you have to do is go to ncresidency.org, fill out a short questionnaire, and they'll get back to you about your residency status, and you won't be able to submit it without it. So before you are ready to complete all of your application things, make sure you've done your residency.
Viability.
Ability to be done in a practical or useful way.
The viability of the solution is questionable.
Career and technical education helps students explore and prepare to enter college, a career, or technical occupation.
We have many CTE classes available to you here at MHS.
Let's check in on some recent CTE classes as well as say goodbye to one of our CTE teachers.
Ms. Bartman, we are going to miss you. We love you.
I want to thank you sincerely from the bottom of my heart.
She's always willing to help and do whatever she can.
I hear people say, well, everybody's replaceable. Honestly, I don't know that Ms. Parkman is replaceable.
If you want to do anything industrial for a job, I would take this class. It's very fun. You get to work with all sorts of things, learn about a lot of things, and it's just really fun to do.
Students, we've got some news for you.
We have this year's prom theme and information that you might need to know.
Drum roll, please.
This year's theme is Tropical Oasis.
It's currently scheduled for Saturday, April 27th from 7 to 11 p.m.
We'll be sure to let you all know when tickets become available.
The Mooresville Public Library is a great place to get involved.
Sophia checked in to see what is happening.
Hey guys, this is Ms. Mosha from the Mooresville Public Library, and I'm here to tell you about everything going on this month. This month we're talking all about things related to STEM. So next Thursday at 6:30, we have a Women in STEM panel. On Mondays, we are offering a Girls Who Code Club at 6 o'clock at our West Branch location. And then first Saturday of every month at 11, we have our Teen STEM program. So check us out.
Students, we want you to be a responsible member of our school.
Here are some ways to be all in.
Hi, Mooresville High School. So we've started our second semester. Second semester is a fresh start for you to get the grade that you desire. Make sure that you communicate with your instructors and all your teachers, letting them know if anything comes up, if you're going to be out. Make sure that if you go over 6 days, that you make up your time as soon as possible. Also, seniors, if you are going to colleges or university, please make sure that you have filled out college applications. Let the county counselors know if you have gotten acceptance letters so that we can highlight you on social media. If you need scholarships, please go ahead and fill those out now. If you're going into employment and you want to navigate different avenues, please see Mr. Wilson or your counselor so that we can help get you connected with some job opportunities. Everyone can be successful, and we are here to help you. Love you all. Have a great semester.
Hannah.
And I'm Trey.
Baking Club is having a bake sale February 14th.
Our stands will be set up inside MAG and inside the pack. It's only cash only.
I want to thank all the families that came out and students that came out to our open house. It was very successful for you to make connections with your teachers. I want to thank all of the faculty and staff that stayed in order to meet the families. I love everything you do, staff, for your dedication and your hard work just to make sure that our students are successful. I love you.
We've got some wonderful teachers here at MHS.
Let's meet this week's teacher spotlight.
I'm Hannah Pierce, and I teach PE, and I'm the athletic trainer.
What's one fun fact about yourself?
I can ride a unicycle.
And would you rather see 50 years in the past or 50 years in the future?
50 years in the future.
We've got some good news.
We have a new teacher on campus.
Let's meet Mr. Willis.
Hello, I am Mr. Willis, and what I love about Mooresville High School is the community that we have here. I'm actually a graduate of Mooresville High School in 2017, so it's nice being back and getting to teach here. Before coming to Mooresville High School, I was working in a research lab pursuing a PhD in chemistry, but now we're here teaching, so.
Did you know that there are many teachers with side gigs displaying their various talents?
Parker was at a holiday event to share more.
Teachers had a Christmas holiday market where any of the teachers who have some little side hustles or hobbies had a chance to come and sell their goods to our fellow teachers. I, for instance, make really ridiculous earrings, and so I sold those, and it was really a fun time for us just to hang out and shop and enjoy what each other made.
You may or may not be aware that Coach Watson has been out dealing with some health issues.
Let's do a quick check-in to see how he's doing.
Hello, this is Coach Watson. I'm glad to be back this semester. Many of you know that I was diagnosed with lung cancer, stage 4, back in April. This past year, in October 17th, I had lung surgery, which is kind of outside the box. And they did that and radiation. I had a scan December 14th, pretty good-looking scan. The adrenal gland has kind of gone away, so I'm back at work this semester, just trying to fight the good fight, and so glad to be here with y'all.
We started a series last semester to see some of the ways that teachers decorate their classrooms.
Let's start off the new year by taking a peek in a few more rooms.
Bonjour, welcome to my classroom. I love my space. I think it's very bright and fun and inviting. My favorite part of my classroom is my window. I love my window. Even on like rainy days, you can still see the sky, which is really nice. I have just student work everywhere you look. That's just all my kids from many, many years of being here at my school.
We appreciate all the staff at MHS.
Let's say hello to Miss Kennedy.
Hey Blue Devils, I'm Mrs. Kennedy. I'm the student support facilitator here at the high school. My primary job is to work with students in their attendance. If they have questions about their attendance, my door is always open and I'm happy to talk to you. And a fun fact about me is I used to be a probation officer in New York.
We are excited to be back with this week's Student Spotlight.
Hey, I'm Anna Dunham. I am a competitive rugby player. I've been playing for almost a year. I'm on the NC All-Stars team, and I've committed to Newberry College on a rugby scholarship.
Be sure to check out the improv night in the Black Box Theater Monday at 6 p.m.
Only $3 for entry.
Y'all know what time it is.
It's time for club news.
The MHS Esports Club is back for the spring semester.
If you want to play games like Fortnite or Valorant, join them after school a few days a week in room A118 until 4 p.m.
Look in the student group in Canvas to find out more details and to sign up.
The chess club will meet Wednesdays in room B118 after school.
There will be an NHS meeting on Monday after school in the pack.
Here are some more club meetings for you.
As always, if you have a club announcement for the show, send it to this email.
The Environmental Club participated in a holiday hike over break.
Let's find out more about the day.
So Miss Barber took the Environmental Club on a hike to Crowder Mountain. It was about a 3-mile hike. It was pretty fun. Had a blast.
This week's club feature is the Debate Club.
Let's see what the debate is all about.
Do you like to debate? Join the Debate Club. The Debate Club helps students to deepen their understanding and improve critical thinking skills. Each meeting, students are given a topic and a side to support for the debate. Students gather evidence in order to fight for their side. And the great thing is, it's free. You can join at any time. Our next meeting is January 23rd in room A226. Be there.
Did you guys know that the BDU is as old as I am, starting all the way back in 2006?
Now you know. It's time for sports.
Let's send it to our sports reporters to get the action.
Welcome to sports.
I'm Lindsay.
I'm Sierra.
And I'm Kalia.
And we're your sports anchors.
Let's see how some of our athletes performed this past week.
I just wanted to give a little recap of our swim season this year. We had a really great season. We had lots of new people come out. We had a lot of returners, some awesome seniors. We're getting to honor them at their senior meet tonight on January 10th. And we wrap up our season next week with conference.
Take it off of me.
Hey,
Jalen.
Hey, Jay. It's Kyrie, man.
Yeah.
I ain't gonna lie, the game versus Cosmere, we almost let them come back, but we did pull away.
Game was close. All game, we had an 8-point lead. Towards the end of the game, you know, things got a little shaky, but we ended up pulling it out.
I just did the NCAA night, and if you're thinking about doing sports in college, then come see me. I've got more information for you.
The men's golf interest meeting is Thursday, January 18th after school in Coach Sis's room, A316.
It should only last around 10 to 15 minutes. Make sure to attend.
Tonight is senior night for our seniors at 6 p.m. in our main gym, so don't hesitate to support our seniors.
There's also a wrestling match on Friday starting at 5. Make sure to attend.
Lastly, our varsity men and women's basketball team play starting at 6 next Tuesday.
We have a new segment for 2024 that we can't wait to show you. So here is our athlete TikTok of the week.
Look, I just flipped the switch. I don't know nobody else is doing this.
That's it for your Blue Devil Sports.
We are so excited about our 2024 sports this year.
Back to you, Melanie and Ben.
Time to find out the forecast from Quince for this week.
Oh, hey, I saw you there this time. This is your weekly weather update with Quince, and I have no ideas. This mic is even real. You know, things have just been falling apart recently, but that's okay. Let's just get into the weather this week. It's gonna be cold, it's been cold, it's gonna stay cold. It's cold. Thank y'all.
And now for my favorite segment.
It's time for PC with PC.
Pop culture time.
What you doing? Doing something for BDB?
Yeah.
Pop culture.
Nice.
The Mandalorian journeys to the big screen. A 13-year-old became a bigger winner and loser than me by beating Tetris for the very first time.
Get a hold of your mother. She's going to want to know about this. Usher is performing at the Super Bowl halftime show.
Let's take a break to have a moment with Maverick.
We're asking MHS what women they know. Name one woman.
Oh, what?
Any one of them.
Taylor Swift.
Taylor Swift. Okay, thank you. That's a great woman. Can you name a woman?
What do you mean?
Can you name a woman?
Just any?
Any woman.
Taylor Swift.
Taylor Swift, that's a great woman.
Do you ever wonder what happens behind the scenes on our show?
Even if you don't wonder, we're going to show you.
Hey guys, this is Behind the BDU. Today we're taking a look into the extensive process that goes into anchoring. All they have to do is practice basic reading skills and they can barely do that. And this is Sophia doing nothing like usual.
That's a lie. That's literally a lie, bro.
She literally doesn't do anything.
We're cutting that off.
That's all for today, Devils.
Make sure to follow us on Instagram at Blue Devil Update to stay in the know of all things Devil.
We are happy to be back and we'll see you all next week.
Bye.
New Year's resolutions. We all got them. Let's hear what our Devils had to say about it.
My New Year's resolution is to make more money.
All right, I would like to work on punctuality.
Get to school on time.
Drink more water.
I just want to better myself overall.
Reading more books for pleasure.
I really need a job.